We have our first phone caller on the line, Mark from Washington County. He has a question about insurance. Mark, you can go ahead with your question now.
Yeah. Can you hear me?
We can, Mark. Hey, Mark. Hey, Mark.
Hello?
Go ahead, Mark. We can hear you.
Yeah, okay. If you have Florida insurance and you get involved in another state and that person injures you in a car accident in that state, what laws do the Florida insurance laws be bought in that state use for your, and the police say that that person is at fault, but his insurance company is denying that he's at fault and I got injured. So what laws do the Florida law be used in another state with the insurance that I have, or I had to use the Alabama insurance law when someone gets injured in that state? How that works?
That's an excellent question. You know, here living in the tri-state area, we have a lot of people that commute back and forth between Florida, Alabama, and Georgia, and vice versa. And so it's not uncommon for us to have people come into our office that were maybe involved in an accident in Georgia or in Alabama, or maybe they're an Alabama or Georgia resident, they're involved in an accident in Florida. And that's always a great question. You know, what law is going to apply? And of course, the traditional lawyer answer of it depends kind of applies in this situation. But really, it depends on what type of coverage you're talking about. Now, in Alabama, people driving a motor vehicle are required to have a minimum amount of bodily injury liability insurance of, I believe it's $20,000 per claim. That's a state minimum. Georgia, it's $25,000 per claim. That's for them to pay you for your injuries if they are found to be at fault. Florida does not have a mandatory bodily injury liability claim. We're one of two states in the entire country that does not have this yet. And I say yet because I'm hopeful that the Florida legislature this year is going to pass mandatory bodily injury. Because right now, if you're in Florida, you get involved in a wreck, there's a pretty good chance you're going to be hit by somebody that doesn't have any sort of protection to protect you from having to incur all those medical bills and lost wages that sometimes unfortunately flow from a motor vehicle wreck. But going back to your question, the other person's liability insurance is going to be available to compensate you. Now, you may have a benefit, or you will have a benefit if you're in your own vehicle and you're up in Alabama, because you have a Florida insurance policy. Florida insurance policies are governed by Florida contract law, and so Florida law would apply to any interpretation of your policy. Now, on your policy, you have that PIP coverage, personal injury protection. That is the $10,000 medical benefit that is tied to your own policy. If you are in your own vehicle and you're involved in a wreck out of state, your PIP insurance is going to be your primary medical coverage for your bills until it runs out. And then once it runs out, the other person's liability coverage would be on the hook if they are found to be at fault. And then beyond that, if you have uninsured motorist coverage, we've talked about that a lot on the show. That's the type of insurance that if you're injured by somebody that doesn't have insurance or doesn't have enough insurance, your uninsured motorist coverage would go on top of that. So to answer your question, both Alabama law and Florida law would apply in that situation. Just depends on the type of coverage. But it sounds like it's a pretty serious situation. And Mark, if you want to give us a call, we'll be happy to walk you through it. And if there's anything we can do to help you out, we'll certainly do so. Brian, you know, we see this a lot with Alabama. Now, in Mark's case, he's in his own vehicle. But, you know, sometimes those PIP benefits, if you're in a friend's vehicle, if you're maybe you're in a rental car, you know, the laws aren't always the same. And I mean, what happens if you're in a rental car, if you're riding in a friend's vehicle and you're involved in a wreck up in Alabama? What happens to your benefits on your own policy at that point?
In that situation, you might not actually be entitled to your personal injury protection benefits. It's unfortunately just the way the Florida law is written and your contract is written. The other thing I just wanted to cover briefly is the statute of limitations vary in state to state. So for instance, we have clients who reside in Tennessee but get in a car accident in Florida, but the statute of limitations to sue on your insurance contract is only 1 year in Tennessee, which is relatively short in lawyer terms. So those are all sorts of things that we have to work with every single day with out-of-state policies, but applying Tennessee law, but for a Florida car accident.